Hello students, in last class we saw that why secondary memories are used. Secondary memories are especially used or mainly used for keeping the things for a longer time, for permanent. We have various secondary memories made out of various different technologies. So in our subsequent classes, we'll see various memories along with the technology used for making them and what are the differences between various secondary memories. One thing should be very clear in your mind that whatever or whichever kind of secondary memory is, the purpose is almost same, to keep the things permanently. Yes. Permanently or for longer time. Why I'm saying these two statements, either permanently or longer time? Look, student, nothing is permanent. You know this. Let us take example of hard disk. If you have stored anything in hard disk, it is stored in form of magnetic charges. So it may be stored in for longer time or for 1,000 years. After that, something may happen to the charge. If you have stored anything in a CD or DVD, it remains there. If any kind of scratch is formed, then you can't read the CD or DVD. Similarly, magnetic tapes are there. Semiconductor memories are there. They, of course, keep the things for a very long time, maybe 500 years, 1,000 years, or even more. So that is a quite lengthy duration. And that's why we can say that, yes, they can store the things permanently. Okay. So keeping this in your mind, let us continue. So first we'll see. Look. Let us take help of Google to get a better idea of secondary memory and computer data storage or secondary memory are almost same thing. Computer data storage is a technology consisting of computer components and recording media that are used to retain digital data. It is a core function and fundamental computer component of computer. When storing data is very important. Okay. So here you can find a lot of different terms are related with the memories, like primary storage, we have already seen. Secondary storage, we have to see. In the same way, volatility, mutability, these all are different terms related with computer's memory. But in this session, we have to see what is a secondary memory. And once you have understood what is a primary memory and what is a secondary memory, then you can understand the other related terms. So secondary storage, which is also known as auxiliary memory, differs from primary storage as it is not directly accessed by the CPU. So here comes the first difference between the primary and the secondary memory. Secondary memories are such memories which are not directly accessed by CPU. Students, you well know that CPU's task is to understand the instructions, process accordingly, and then send back the process data. So from where does the CPU fetch the data? So it's not the secondary memory, it's the primary memory which is directly connected with the CPU. And primary memory is connected with secondary memory, which I just shown you in the last video, how the things are connected. So the things goes from secondary memory to primary memory. How it happens? Let us try to understand this with an example. When you want to open any program, either Word, Excel, or a game, or a media player, or anything, What do you normally do? You double click if you are using a laptop or desktop, or you tap the icon when you are using the smartphones or touch devices. So when you double click it, you are simply sending the command to open that. And yes, all the programs, all the apps, all the softwares are loaded in secondary memory. Why? Because primary memory cannot hold the things for permanent. It is a temporary memory. It's a volatile memory. Primary memory is a volatile memory. So things are normally stored in whenever you install any app, whenever you, installing means when you put some software in your system, that is called installation. Then it gets installed into or stored into secondary storage. And whenever you double click or want to open any app or program, the data is fetched from secondary storage to the primary memory, and then the interaction begins, the cycle begins of execution of that program. A smaller programs takes less time. If you are using any simple program like Notepad or something, let me show you. If I'm trying to open a small program like Notepad, it just instantly got opened, okay? Because it didn't took so much time. It's a small program. And if we'll try to open a little bigger program, then you just see, I'm trying to open Access. Although my system is very fast, but still it took a little more time than that. It's very fast computer, so you'll not find that the time duration. But in your system, you may try, if you have a normal computer, I'm just trying to tell you that a bigger program takes larger time to get opened. If you'll open any game, is the best example, then you may see that it takes more time than as compared to the other apps. And even the bigger games take even more time. And so loading, this kind of something is displayed in front of you. It's loading. And the percentage status bar goes on. So what is this loading while opening any game? Game also is an app, I believe, it's a larger program. So loading means loading the content from secondary memory, usually the hard disk, to RAM, that is the primary memory. And then the execution of that program starts and we let our task done. We get our task done. So this is how things happen. This is how the connection between the secondary memory or the primary memory is there. So dear students, we just see that how the things get loaded from secondary memory to primary memory. Now the question may be, why not the CPU is directly connected with the secondary memory? Why RAM is needed? So the answer to this question is, there are a lot of differences between primary and the secondary memory. One of the difference you just came to know that in primary memory, things cannot be stored for permanent, but in secondary, it can be stored for longer time. The second and the important difference is secondary memories are slower, quite very slower than the primary memories. As compared to the primary memories, secondary memories are slower. But the processor, the technology out of which the processor is made, the CPU is made, is very, very fast. And for faster execution, the CPU needs fast delivery of data and instructions, which secondary memory cannot do. Secondary memory is slow. Why it is slow, we'll also come to know when we'll discuss more about the technology being used for making them. That will let you know that, oh, this is the reason because of which these memories are slow. Just for right now, you may keep in your mind that secondary memories are slower than the primary memory. And therefore, primary memory, since it is fast and since it can fastly deliver data and instruction to the processor, therefore that there is a utility of primary memory also. Secondary memories are slower. So this is the reason because of which CPU can't be directly connected to the secondary memory. So up to this point, I hope that you might have understood what is a secondary memory, why it is being used in a system, what is the relation between the primary and the secondary memory, what is the relation with this CPU. So now we'll let us go according to this. In modern computers, wow. Look, student, if you'll see older books or even the book that you have got to study, you might not get the updated details regarding the technology and the advancement. Maybe because they have been printed 1 or 2 years back, the writer have not mentioned about the new technologies. But when we are learning it online, when you'll learn it through the internet, you will come to know about various new technologies. And since you are learning computers, so you need to be updated. Yes, these are the new technologies. These are now happening. So in modern computer, hard disk drives. Okay, dear students, there was some internet fault. So I was telling you the modern technologies. So look, hard disk is still the most widely and the most reliable and one of the best, you may say, secondary storage device which are used in almost all the computers. Hard disk drive. Look at this diagram. This is a typical hard disk. This is a circular plate. This is an arm which has read and write head. This arm is used to read or write data in this plate. And so many plates are there, not only one plate. And this is covered, and hard disk look like this. Another, you may say, new technology has emerged nowadays, which is known as SSD, solid state drives. Look, a solid state drive is a solid state storage that is used integrated circuit assemblies to store data, typically using flash memory. Let me make the point clear. Normal hard disk drive, since you're watching these things for the first time, things may get a little complicated for you, but this is a hard disk, and this is a hard disk. Another is SSD. Both of them look same. When they are covered, they look same. But the difference is, a normal hard disk drive, is made up of this. I mean, it has metallic plates coated with magnetic material. It has an arm. It has a motor. Look, if you want to know more about a hard disk, see, hard disk It is also known as fixed disk, is an electronic data storage device which uses magnetic technology to store and retrieve digital data. So you may get a lot of idea by reading these things, but let me make the things simple for you. Look at this diagram also. This is a circular plate. Look at this. This is a motor on which these plates are stacked. From the top view, you can see only one plate, but it has a lot of plates, more than one plates. And this is an arm, which do the task of reading or writing the data over the disk. This is a motor which rotates a disk. And yes, motor has got some speed, like 5400 RPM, 7200 RPM, that is mentioned on the hard disk itself. Means if you have 5400 RPM hard disk, it simply means that the motor rotates at this speed. 5400 rotation per minute, RPM full form, rotation per minute. So look how speed this motor is moving. And thus it works fast, faster than other memory devices. But nowadays, solid state drives has came. Solid state drives are made up of different technology. They do not contain plate, they do not contain motor, they do not contain arms to read. They are made out of technology of flash memory. Flash memory means pen drives. So the technology with which pen drives are made, using the same technology, these solid state devices are made. They have no physical movement of moving motor and reading heads and like. It is one of the example of semiconductor storage device, semiconductor. Okay. So solid state devices used integrated circuit. Semiconductor means integrated circuits are used for making this. Using flash memory, pen drives are also known as flash memory. This is our secondary memory class and we'll come to know about all these things. And is functioning as a storage device or secondary storage and all. So now the question is there any difference between normal hard disk drive or say what this one, solid state drives? So dear students, there is a really very large difference. And the difference is of speed. Yes. SSDs are much, much faster than normal hard disk drives. In my computer, I have 500 GBs of SSD and my computer do not take more than 10 seconds to start because of that. If I would have used simple hard disk, then it would have taken around 30 seconds. So SSDs are faster memories. They are little costlier, but they are fast. So this is a difference between simple hard disk. See, we are learning hard disk right now. It is one of the secondary storage device. But since it's a new era, we are learning the modern technologies also. So here we have two hard disks, two types of hard disks. One is simple hard disk drive, which contains plates, which contains arm, which contains motors, which is typically there in all the systems. But we have another type of hard disk, which is solid state drives, which do not contain plates and all. They use flash memory or semiconductor or IC technology for making a memory. The difference between them is, by look, if you'll physically see them, they will look similar, unless you dismantle them. Dismantling means uncovering and just removing the outer covers and all, then you will find the difference. Otherwise, they look same. But the difference is in their speed. They are very fast. Hard disk drives, normal hard disk, this normal hard disk uses magnetic technology, whereas solid state device use semiconductor or IC technology. What is magnetic technology? What is semiconductor technology? That also we'll see, but not now. We'll see in our subsequent classes. So let us see further what is this. Another term is the access time per byte is typically measured in millisecond, 1/1000th of the second. If you'll divide a second into 1000 part, then it is called 1 millisecond. So access time, the time to access data, is measured in millisecond in these hard disks, while the access time per byte for a primary storage is measured in nanosecond, 1/1000th of the second. 1/1000th, you know. If you'll divide million means 10 lakhs and billion means 1000 lakhs. I mean, it's very, very small interval of time. So you can clearly find that what is the access time of these devices? They are just measured in millisecond, the 1000th of a second. Let me make this point very clear. What is 1 billion? Look, 1 billion. It's 1 Arab in our traditional way we call it. So this is 1 billion. If you'll divide a second into these many parts, 1 Arab parts, see how fast this works. So this is the speed of primary memory, and that's what I was trying to make you clear. Primary memories are measured in nanoseconds, whereas these are measured in millisecond. Why nano, why milli? Because the secondary storage are slower than the primary memory. So dear students, these are very important and crucial points. So you must understand these things very clearly. Thus, secondary storage is significantly slower than this. Now another thing starts. Rotating optical storage, such as CD, DVD, have even longer access time. We just saw here that HDD, I mean hard disk drive or SSD, are faster. Good enough. Where is optical storage device? Optical storage devices, you know, this is the optical disk drive in which we insert CD, DVD or Blu-ray disc, and then it reads the data. CD you well know, DVD you also know. So these are another example of secondary storage. These are even more slower than hard disks and SSDs, even more slower. Further, we have other secondary technologies, including USB flash drive, the pen drives that we use. Yes, this is the USB flash drive. We normally call it pen drive. Then we have floppy disk, which is not now. See, these are four types of floppies. These are used in earlier days. Now they are not used. A floppy, also known as floppy disk, is simply this is type of disk. It contains a thin flexible plastic disk and used to store data. These were very unreliable disks. I had used these disks, but they are not reliable. Reliable means if you want to store data, it's not sure that next time when you will try to read, it will be readable. It get corrupt very easily. Another old technology is magnetic tape. These are the old technologies. Magnetic tapes are storage device having tape, a plastic tape having magnetic material coating over them. You might have seen video cassettes, audio cassettes, which were used earlier, few years back, 10 to 12 years back, 15 years back. We are used to listen music through audio tapes. Yes. So those were the example of magnetic tapes. Those can also be used. Let me click it and show you the diagram, if the diagram is available here. These are the magnetic tape. Look, this diagram. Older technologies. If you will study them in detail, you'll find they are the older technologies. They are not used nowadays because we have a lot of new paper tapes. Were even used much earlier than the magnetic tapes. Look, it was widely used during much of the 20th century for teleprinter communication input of this 1950s to 60s. They are even older devices. If you really want to know how they were, punch card, even older. So these all are the examples of secondary storage, RAM disk. RAM drive is a block of random access memory that computer software treating as if memory were a disk drive. It's sometimes referred to as virtual RAM drive or software RAM from the hardware RAM. And look, let me make the point here clear. What happens sometimes that in few computers, in older computers, we have very less RAM, 512 MB of RAM or 1 GB of RAM. But nowadays, we need more RAM for running larger programs. So what happens? Some part of hard disk is reserved as RAM. Yes. Which is also called virtual memory. Memory employs the primary and the main memory. But in case when the RAM which exists in your machine seems low, I mean, if more RAM is needed, then at that instant, you cannot put a new RAM there. No? So what operating system does, operating system reserves a space of hard disk and use it like a RAM. Although it will be slower, but it uses either. That is all called a virtual memory or the RAM disk. So, okay, dear students, in this class, this much discussion is enough. We'll see something more in our next class.